Hello there, Internet people. It's your good buddy, Rue. I'm here to talk to you about comics. I have decided, if you haven't noticed from the title, to stop dating these things because, you know what, past 3 weeks I haven't done them once a week, and I'm not going to pigeonhole myself into that. Call it laziness, call it whatever you want. It's just not going to happen. Thor's back, and I don't know how long he's going to stay. He actually seems pretty friendly today. I don't know what's going on with that. But here we go. Starting off with S.W.O.R.D. by Marvel, issues 1 through 3. Look at that. This is actually a really fun series. I get why most people don't like the art. I think that works in the context of this series. And these comics are worth it only because Lockheed is awesome. And this series is so much fun. It is so awesome. It is so niche-y. I think something that's in a niche, not something that is niche-y, that it's already been canceled. Those were issues 1 through 3, and issue 5 is the final issue. So, you know what? I guess at this point in time, just wait for trade, if you even care at all. Okay, moving on. X-Men Forever, number 15. I know that there's a very small contingent of us that actually like this book. Whatever. This honestly might have been one of my top favorite books so far of this series. Actually, this is the best book issue of this series so far. Claremont is the only person ever to make me care about Storm, whether she's good or evil. This book was almost nearly perfectly written. The only, there's three pages where we weren't dealing with Storm and the Black Panther and a whole bunch of other things. Those pages were stupid. Everything else in this book was really good. If you're like me and you think that the marriage of Storm to the Black Panther in the Marvel Universe proper was stupid and made no sense, pick up this one issue of X-Men Forever and just enjoy it. And hopefully you'll buy more. If not, that's fine. But I really think that this was a very, very, very good comic. Amazing Spider-Man 617. Another really good comic this week. I'm very happy. Joe Kelly did something I never thought possible. Made me care about the Rhino. Oh, and I'm sorry. Look at that. Look at that, buddy. Look. This is a really, really cool cover to a comic book. Maybe I'm just too easily amused. But I really like this cover. I really like this comic. I cared about the Rhino. I was rooting for the Rhino. I want him to do well now. I want him to stay on the straight and narrow. If you're just one of those people who just kind of picks up Amazing Spider-Man based on the team, the art team, this is Joe Kelly. He's awesome. And the art was much better than the Electro and Sandman storylines. Oh my god, that art sucked. But more importantly, this was just a good story. And it actually, there was an emotional attachment to what was going on. I was rooting for the Rhino, I was rooting for Spider-Man, and I know this is going to get overplayed a lot, but this is definitely one for the win column. Moving on, this is actually a pretty short week. This might not go all 10 minutes. Buffy the Vampire Slayer, number 31. I know that every couple months I say I'm going to drop this book eventually, and I'm going to drop this book eventually. Apparently I'm a glutton for punishment. This was another meh issue, except for Xander going off on Buffy, and rightfully so, finally, after, I guess, 8 years or whatever, however long they've been hanging out, going off on him, going off on her for using him all the time. Seriously, this book was meh. I'm going to give this through the Twilight storyline just to find out what's going on with that. But the art, the story, I'm just not feeling it anymore. One thing, though, that I just realized was the bad guy's name is Twilight, and this is a vampire book. I'm actually kind of annoyed by that, but you know what? It took me 31 issues to get the joke, so that's my fault, so I'm not going to be mad at anybody else but me for that. Daytripper number 2. I'm not sure, I don't remember if I reviewed Daytripper number 1 for you guys, but this series is awesome. 2 issues in, and I want issue 3. I want this whole thing in my hand right now. I don't want to wait for trade for a year and a half till all 12 comics are collected. I want the trade now. I want this whole story. This is just a breath of fresh air in what comics can do. I'm thoroughly enjoying this. It's Vertigo. It's only up to issue 2. I'm sure you can find 1 and 2 if you go to your comic book shops or whatever. Pick this up. Don't trade rate this. Let these guys know, Moon and Bob, the guy, writer and artist, let them know that this is a book that should be, praised. The fact that it's only, I think, a 12 issue, maybe 18 issue miniseries, whatever, makes me, hopeful that they have a very good plan in mind. So pick this up, read it. Me and the fourth man over at the outhouse, we can't praise this enough. go for it. And speaking of the Outhousers, if you ever wanted to know what was going on inside Brian Reed's head, you know, the writer of such things as Ms. Marvel and Siege Embedded, head on over to theouthousers.com. That's theouthousers.com, where you will download a podcast interview that the Outhousers did with Brian Reed over the weekend. Yes, the Brian Reed, to go along with our interviews of Chris Claremont, Charlie Houston, and a whole bunch of other people. Theouthousers.com, otherwise known as Boosh. Bring it. DMZ number 49. I praise this book every month. I'm not going to praise it again. Just, I'm not going to waste much of your time, but holy fucking shit. Please, anybody who's watching this, if you read this book, holy fucking shit, dude. Yes. Please go to, again, theouthouses.com. Vote in our comic book awards for Brian Wood. Although, and I fought for this, DMZ is not nominated. Northlanders is. Find a way, vote for Brian Wood. He deserves it based solely on this issue alone, but also Northlanders, DMZ. These are my top five comics every month. I love, I've not read anything but Brian Wood I don't like. If anybody out there can find me something that they think I won't like, you know, fine, I'll try it out because I like Brian Wood and I'm willing to give anything he writes a chance. Damn fucking good comic. Go to the Outhousers, register and vote for the awards. And we're going to send statues and stuff, people. Whatever. Go team. And finally, just some new books that I tried out, just based on me being manic in a comic book store. And when I get manic, I'm a spender. This one is called Orc Stain. I basically picked this up because seriously, some of the detail in this pencil work is amazing. Again, I'm not really the world's biggest guy who buys based on art, but this really grabbed my eye. It looked like it'd be a fun little read. As I was reading it, though, I will say that I wasn't very impressed at the beginning. It kind of was reading like some adolescent softcore porn fantasy series that somebody just wanted to draw boobs and violence. Excuse me. But as I kept going, I actually got kind of interested in the story. I'm not saying that it's perfect. Like, the art is phenomenal. The story isn't everything, but it got me interested enough to see what's going on with issue two. I'm going to give another chance. Not perfect, but definitely give this a shot if you're just looking for something that might be fun and you don't really have to think too much. And again, this is just gorgeous, gorgeous coloring, gorgeous artwork. Go for it. And finally this week, Weekly World News number one. That's right. Weekly World News is, I guess the subject, I don't know if they're publishing it or how they're working with IDW, it's a comic book. Basically, it's set in a world where the Weekly World News is the most trusted news source. And so hilarity ensues. You have Batboy, you have aliens, you have demons, you have all these other things. I really enjoy the concept of this. I hope that this series lasts long enough so that the writer can find his voice a bit better. A lot of the jokes, this is a funny book, it's not a parody book, but it's a funny book. A lot of the jokes seemed forced and the timing was a bit off. But I think that just the sheer idea of the story can lead to some really, really fun ideas in the future. So I'm enjoying it. I'm going to give this book a shot. IDW's putting it out. It has the art for it's really good. I think Thor's leaving us. I hope he doesn't knock over the computer. Hold on. There he goes. Computer safe. We're safe. Go team. So Weekly World News. Give it a shot. Orc Stain. If you have a couple bucks to spare and you're like, well, that is kind of really cool art, give that a chance too. But honestly, X-Men Forever number 15 was by far the surprise good book of the week. And DMZ, oh my fucking God. Catch you guys later. Enjoy. And later, peeps.